I represent Marte Monguno, Ngenzei, Federal Constituency of Borno State. Mr. Speaker, honorable members, my contribution for the second reading of this bill will be anchored on the issue of budget implementation. Mr. Speaker, honorable members, budgets, no matter how beautifully couched, budgets, no matter how beautifully drafted, remains in the realm of mere estimates and wishful thinking, so long as they are not implemented to the latter. So long as budgets are not implemented to the latter, then Nigerians will be deprived of enjoying bringing dividends of democracy to their doorsteps. Against this backdrop, Mr. Speaker, I want to commend on the dismal implementation of budgets that has constituted a cog in the wheel of our developmental aspiration in this country. Year in, year out, the National Assembly, as a body that is constitutionally mandated for the purpose of making appropriation in this country, we are doing our job by passing the budget. But when it comes to implementation, we always have a problem of implementing the budget. So against this backdrop, there is a need for this parliament, as representative of the people and as a responsible, responsive parliament to the yearnings and aspirations of the people that gave us the sacred mandate to represent them, to take the bull by the horn and pace the executive on this issue of budget implementation. For example, it was only this morning I was reading the This Day newspaper, page 6 of today. It says, all revenue has exceeded 2017 budget benchmark by 18%. And they are quoting NNPC. If the benchmark for all revenue for 2017 has been exceeded by 18%, I see no reason why at this stage we are now thinking about dismal implementation of the budget if we have exceeded the benchmark by 18%. By now, we should have implemented the budget by at least 60-70%. But now we are talking in the realm of 10%. I know agencies under that oversighting only go 10% of the budget. So what is the problem? There must be a problem somewhere. So there is a need for us to emphasize on the implementation of the budget. We should perform our oversight role as given to us by the Constitution so that budgets are implemented to the latter, so that Nigerians can enjoy the dividends of democracy that is contained in the budget. Because no matter how beautifully couched a budget is, no matter how beautifully presented, if it is not implemented, remains in the realm of wishful thinking and mere estimates. So there is a need as a legislature to engage the executive and know what are the problems that constitute a cog in the wheel of implementation of the budget. If on the revenue profile, the revenue aspect, we don't have constraint, as clearly stated by NNPC today, then why is it that we are not implementing the budget? Is it bureaucratic reptapism? Is it bureaucratic bottleneck? What are really the problems? If there is a need for us to have legislative intervention with regard to certain laws that are dragging the implementation of the budget, then we can amend such laws so that the budget can be implemented in the interest of Nigerians. But that notwithstanding, the 2018 budget is beautiful. There is significant improvement. For example, to the agri sector in tandem with the diversification policy of the government that the government has been, is preaching, though I have not been able to meet the 10% Maputo declaration that urged all African countries to devote at least 10% of their budget to the agricultural sector, but there is significant improvement in the allocation to the agri sector. And our consolation as a country is that agriculture is in the concurrent legislative list. The federal government funds agriculture. The state governments also fund agriculture. So we should emphasize on budget implementation. That is my own submission. Thank you very much.